Servus, thanks for dropping in. Today I have something special for all the plinkers. It's the 9-shot air pistol Diana Bandit. Have fun, guys. Yes, it's about time to show something a bit lower priced. Recommended retail price 190 €, which is a super fair price. What do you get for your money? I'd say we start with the technical data. Then we'll look at some close-ups. No crony test today, I'll tell you why in a few minutes. But of course, we'll have a shooting test and the final result. Technical data. 51 centimeter long including the silencer, a weight of 1000 gram, and we have a 9-shot magazine and a single shot adapter included. There's a compressed air system with 200 bar pressure and a volume of 50 milliliters. It was enough for me to take about 120 to 125 shots yesterday before the power decreased massively. That's a really good result. I started with around 7.5 joule power at 200 bar. After 60 shots, you reach round about 140 to 150 bar and a power of 5.5 joule. Shortly before it was empty, I was still at 4 joule. Which is more than a Weirach HW40. Can it reach the same precision? Well, it's kind of unfair to compare, but we'll have a closer look later. About the system, you see the bolt handle. Up on top there's an 11 mm prism rail. After removing the rear sight, you can attach a red dot or even a scope. I'd say we'll take a look at the close-ups now, before we head to the shooting test. So, this is the close-up. In the front you can see the silencer. You can see the front sight or match sight over here. Down there is the manometer, which I'll show you in detail in a second. The barrel here, caliber 4.5 millimeters, 0.177. The bolt handle with the pin that pushes the Diabolo into the barrel. The grip, which is left and right handed, and it feels really good. And back here, I hope I can show it. Yes, I can. The iron sights. So down here is the safety, which is off right now, and now it's on. Basically, you just move this pin, which then blocks the trigger from being pushed. Pulled. And click. Safety off. Okay, down here you place the adapter to fill the cartridge with a maximum of 200 bar. Now you saw the pistol in detail. I'd say we go for the shooting test. Let's start the shooting test with the Diana Bandit. You can see, or maybe hear, I'm using my new camera for the first time to film the shooting test. In the past I used my smartphone to film from here and my camcorder to film the target. Today, we skipped using the smartphone. It has a good picture, but the sound is really no good at all. Okay, so much for my setup. You can see the magazine here. There are probably two ways to fill the magazine. You can see this clear plastic. I point that downward, and for the first time ever, I am filling a magazine, pushing in the skirt first. Or maybe I'm just dropping it. So here we go again. First time, skirt first, and then you turn the magazine. While holding it into the camera, it's a bit harder to do, but I hope you can see it. Put it in, turn again, and so on. And then you can fill in 9 pellets, and I'll show you the single shot adapter later. Filling the magazine is super easy after you did it a few times. Of course, at first it took a while, not only because you are just not used to handling the Diabolus the other way around. You probably could also turn the magazine around, but I think it is easier this way. Now I hold it upright so no Diabolo falls out and turn it back into the starting position. You can see the 9 pellets are in the magazine. There's a small notch here, so the magazine can slide in perfectly. Okay, do not wonder, it may look a little stupid, but I got a recommendation from a watcher who is a way better pistol shooter than I am. He recommended to use this eye blinder, so I can aim with both eyes open. I think I got this from Anschutz or Gamon, not sure, but doesn't matter right now. If somebody is interested, I can look it up. Okay, let's shoot.
Dann teste ich jetzt mal aus.
Well, it's a bit better with one eye closed. I'm not really comfortable yet with the eye blinder. I'd say it works a bit better now. The first test on the left target I shot right before this one, but I don't want to bother you with that one. What I wanted to repeat again, JSP exact 4.53mm, 11.5m distance and 9 shots in the magazine. Yeah, let's see if I can finish this with precision. Okay, that's it. 9 shots. Well, I would say the shooting result is more than just acceptable. Shooting iron sights over 11.5 meters and the target area would fit under a 1 euro coin, definitely under a 2 euro coin. Over 11.5 meters, I'm surprised at how good the pistol performs. After all, this is a blinking pistol, not a match pistol. Not bad. Amazing, that's what I call a really good result. For a gun that was, from my point of view, built for blinking, I don't think you need something more precise for blinking over 11.5 meters with a pistol. I am 100% positively surprised. I expected a lot, but not this. Now here's the result. A way better performance than I was expecting, or even hoping for. The shooting result is really good. I'd say it's fake if I wouldn't have been there and got it on tape. It is really good. Repeating goes really smooth 95% of the times. Sometimes it's a little stiff and you have to pull it a bit rougher. The grip is super comfortable. I think it's obvious that this is not made of oak or walnut. You have to do without some things if you want a pistol in this low price range. Another thing I want to show you is how the single shot adapter works. Again, we have a small notch here and you can just push the adapter in from the side. The pellet is filled in from the top and pushed into the barrel. The whole system is very silent, interesting for people who are shooting in a rented apartment, in the basement, the attic, or anywhere they don't want to be too noisy. Everybody who wants to shoot in a club and wants to shoot competitively should look somewhere else. For your warm-up, blinking and training, this might be all right, but I want to stress again that this is not a match weapon. The magazine is a bit unusual at first. If you turn it around, at least that's what I found more comfortable, you fill it with the skirt first. After doing it two or three times, it will come naturally to you. So who would I recommend this air pistol to? Everybody who is fine with shooting an unregulated pistol and who can adapt to the fact that the hit point will move slightly from one magazine to the next. You saw the shooting test, within 9 shots you don't feel a loss of pressure, but comparing the first 10 shots with your 100th shot, your hit point will have moved. Over 10 meters you will feel less change, while shooting tin cans over 20 meters you will have to adapt your aim in terms of aiming a bit higher. Yeah. Fellow blinkers, in case you don't have a pistol yet, this is an interesting one for you. Okay, that's all from me. I hope the camera quality was fine. Like I said, I used a new camera for the first time to film me while shooting, which I did with the smartphone before. I have to check afterwards if this was more convenient for you than the old videos. You know, I'm trying to improve my videos all the time and still have work to do with the camera setup. Okay, that's it. Thank you all for taking the time to watch my video and see you soon. Ciao, Servus, es ist Gandhi.